What actually happened? Because of our own fault, our own weaknesses, people came from all over the world to India. What for? Because India had everything. Everything, you name it, they had it. They took it away and called it their own. And now India is what? Oh, look to the West. Every person from the world looking to the East, to India, and now we're looking to the West. It's a shame. Thank you.
Okay. It's an interesting thing to explore, and I'm going to be cutting as well, because I said ask pointed questions, but sometimes I give pointed answers as well, so watch it. It's an interesting thing to explore. You see, sometimes people say, Dilipbhai, we were a grand civilization, it's just the outsiders who messed us up. Now, it may sound like a simplistic answer that seems to resolve the issue that we were conquered first by the Muslims and then the Christians came and we were ruled by outsiders for nearly 1,000 years, and of course they took away a lot of wealth from India and they took away a lot of skills and a lot of knowledge from India. So let's blame them. You may like to do that. Oh yes, point a finger. These are the villains. My question, there are a lot of doctors here and I like this kind of questions to linking with the medical field, would be this. If you are weak or your immunity is down, even the smallest bacteria can enter your system and demolish you. Isn't it true? So the fact that a handful of people could come and, the East India Company, there were a handful of people. It was almost farcical that this such a small group of people can suddenly exercise control over a whole nation, a huge nation, like a continent. Handful of people literally took over. You see, I'm not suggesting that East India Company were bacteria, I mean, that's a bit too much, but but you see, how can a small group, handful of people, suddenly take over a major nation? That means our immunity was down. Always think like that. Why should you think like that? Because we have still not learned the lesson that you have to be strong within yourself to make sure that the world that you're interacting with does not overwhelm you. Haven't you noticed? If you've got a kid, and Dr. Kaka is smiling, he likes medical stuff here. If you find a kid in your, in a school, and you send him to school and he's not well kind of prepared to stand on his own feet and stand his ground, he's not prepared to do, he's not ready for that, or not set to do that, you send him to school, he'll be bullied. His pocket money will be taken, his lunch will be taken away. So he pays a price. So the important thing is to develop inner strength that raises your immunity system. So when you interact with the greater society, other civilizations, you're able to take it on head on and not be overwhelmed by them or controlled by them or taken over by them. So this is the lesson that I would like to pick up from what the gentleman said. Of course, he means well, he's a patriot. He wants to really lift Hinduism and India up, and I like people like that because they've got some fire in their bellies. And they want to stand up for this religion and protect and promote it. So I'm all for that. But I'm telling the Hindus, please Hindus, look at yourselves, look at your condition. Has your immunity system been bettered than what it was a few hundred years ago when you were taken over? Ask yourself, let me show you. Not really. You see, at the moment, any crass material that the West throws up, crass, when I say superficial, trivial, undignified for humanity, anything the West throws up, India swallows it without salt. A lot of nonsense, that goes around here, and it's very crass and very highly materialistic or highly, almost pornographic. Straight away, India will adopt and become part of this culture. So you see, our immunity has not been improved that much so far. I'm warning you. That is where we are open to these attacks from outside. In the earlier days, the attacks came in sense that there were forces, physical forces, people coming with swords and guns. The attacks that come now, they come through the internet, they come through this kind of strong media that we possess, and they enter our society. You see, in ancient days, if you went to villages in India, they'll be sitting together in the evening. This was routine. They would be sitting together, singing bhajan, singing devotional song, talking of higher ideals, doing Ramayana and enjoying this lovely company of spiritual talks and so on, higher ideals, aspiring to higher principles. Today you drive in any of the villages of India, first of all, every wall in the village is covered with Bollywood dancing girls, and the every house has got television or a radio station blaring away these tunes of Bollywood dancing and singing. Where is your culture? Where is your, see, you are weak. So that's why these ideas have overwhelmed.